Namaste children, I am Indrani from Dalmia Vidya Mandir School, Dalmiapuram. Children, I hope you are all safe at home. Today we are going to see the new poem. The poem topic is The Shed, was written by Frank Fline for grade 7th. The poem topic is The Shed, was written by Frank Fline for grade 7th. Children, what is a shed? Shed is a small room. People use this shed to store things, to store old things like wood and vehicles. People use this shed for animals. In the earliest times, all the people, they lived in the small shed only. They lived happily in that shed. In this poem also, the poet shared his views about his shed only. That shed is in his garden. It is away from his main house. Shall we see the poem, children? See here, first line. There is shed at the bottom of our garden. There is shed at the bottom. Bottom means the lowest point of our, means here the poet's garden. Next line. With a spider's web hanging across the door. The poet could see the spider's web because it was an old shed. That is why the poet said, with a spider's web hanging across the door. Third line, the hinges. Hinges means that movable part. The door attached with that movable part. The hinges are very rusty because it was an old thing. So the hinges are rusty and creak in the wind. While the heavy wind blows, that time they make very big sound. When I am in bed means the poet in bed, I lie, the poet lie and I listen, the poet listen the sound of door when the heavy wind blows. I will open that door one day, the poet wishes he wanted to open the door one day but not now because he was afraid to enter into the shed. That is why he said, I will open that door one day. You understood, children? Again I read, there is shed at the bottom of our garden. That is lowest point in the garden. It was away from his poet's house. With a spider's web. The family members, they could see the spider's web. It was an old shed. With a spider's web hanging across the door. The hinges. Hinges means that movable part. The door attached to that part. That's why the door can move here and there. The hinges are rusty. It was a rusty. Okay. And creak in the wind. When the heavy wind blows, it made sound. When I am in bed, I lie and I listen. The poet listened that sound when he was in bed. I will open the door one day. The poet said, I will open the door one day, but not now. You understood, children? Shall we see the second paragraph, children? Okay. Shall we see the second paragraph, children? See, there is a dusty old window around at the side. Actually, that window full of dust. They didn't clean. So, there is a dusty old window around at the side with three cracked, the window panes of glass cracked. Poet could see the lines, cracked lines in that window with three cracked panes of glass. I often think there is someone staring at me each time that I pass. What the poet said, whenever he passed in that way, he thought someone staring, someone looked at him. That's why the poet said, I often. Here, I means the poet. I often think there is someone. He thought someone is inside. So, he said, whenever he passes, each time that I pass, I often think there is someone staring. Staring means looked firmly. So, I often think there is someone staring at me each time that I pass. I will peep through that window one day. What he said? Definitely, I will see. Okay? I will see inside through the window one day. But not now, the poet said. Okay? Again, I'll read. there is a dusty old window out at the side. The poet could see the old window with three cracked panes of glass. The poet could see the cracked glass. I often think there is someone staring at me. Whenever he passed that way, the poet thought someone looked at him. Each time that I pass means the poet. I will peep. I wanted to see. Peep means see. I wanted to see through that window one day. I will see through the window. Like that he said. But not now. One day he said. You understood these two paragraphs, children? Okay. Next week we are going to see third and fourth paragraph. Thank you, children.